Hey, Tron Collector fans, Flagger here giving you a look at this today, the Marvel Unlimited 2016 Collector's Kit. This is something that you get if you subscribe to the annual subscription, and it allows you to get a figure and comics and basically read all of the digital comics they have online. So this is the new presentation box they have. Let me sharply focus up that a little bit better. So it's a nicely done presentation box. You pay around, I paid about $65 or something with a coupon, but we'll put a link directly underneath. And yes, that seems like a lot, but what it does do is give you full access to all of the, or nearly all of the digital Marvel collection from the past. So really going way, way back, lots of cool comics that otherwise sometimes you might not even be able to get access to. They have them. So there's the box, very small and simple and flat, redesigned from previous years where it was absolutely huge. And there's some of the artwork that's inside there, and the Marvel Unlimited logo, and a little flap, it's always about the flaps, is inside with a couple of different comics and other little goodies inside. So what you do get is three comics inside. So these are variant editions of Captain America White 01, and pretty decent read and lots of decent art inside. But again, you can only get these in this pack. This is a connecting one with Invincible Iron Man. They all connect up together. Much thinner read, but again, this is the relaunch of the Invincible Iron Man. Again, a variant cover with a great story. This is a fantastic story, very movie-like quality story going on in this comic. So that's another one you get. And the other one is, I'm sure very popular with some people, Agent Carter. So again, that's her recent comic, and that's 001, a variant edition of that too. And again, it's kind of hard to hold it all together, but they do all connect. So you get this nice little display if you're really into variant comics. This is the only place you can get these guys, so they're pretty cool. You also get a little letter welcoming you to the club. And a little personalized card, freezer frame if you want to read that. There's lots of other goodies available there. Sometimes they give you access to Netflix shows a little quicker and other stuff there, and that's my card there. You also got inside the pack these little shield pin and an Agent Carter SSR pin going on there too. So again, nicely done with little black studs on the back. But the piece, the resistance that I picked it up for, I had to, of course, Iron Man sleaze that I am, was this. The only place you can get this figure, this is the Marvel Legends Rescue Pepper Potts figure. Rescue is a character that is from the Iron Man lore, of course, and it's a suit made for Pepper, Pepper Potts, and it's Mark 1616 if you want to really know about their suit nerds. But it's the only place that this figure, which was at one point teased by Hasbro to be coming in the Iron Man line in a second wave along with the Mandarin, but never did make it out. So this is the only place you can get this figure, and it's a lot more expensive on eBay just to get the figure rather than is get the kit and get access at least to all the digital comics and goodies. Previous years, the figures have kind of sucked a little bit. Repaints of Rocket Raccoon and other stuff just really didn't do it for me. But getting a good quality figure here, something completely unique and different, was something I had to get. So there's the basic kind of overview of the figure. We'll take you through articulation in just a minute. It's a nicely designed suit. There are some kind of reused or similar elements from before. I believe these thigh pieces have been used before on an Iron Man. I might be wrong. Otherwise, I think it's all completely brand new. It looks almost as if some of these have been used, or the legs in some parts have been used on a previous figure, but certainly the main sculpt is completely unique, which is nice. And again, getting a completely unique figure with Marvel Legends and the subscription is kind of cool. So let's run through the articulation. There's Pepper Bum. The head is beautifully kind of articulated, so we get on a ball joint there and a swivel, so plenty of movement going on. The shoulders are a little bit limited by these shoulder pads, but like previous Iron Man, they are on a hinge, but it's a ball joint there with a hinge. You also get a swivel bicep, you can see that there. You get a double joint at the elbow, so plenty of movement going on, and wrist articulation there, as well as extra back and forth articulation, so she's really got excellent articulation. Same with the other hand, the articulation there, nice little arc reactors on the, or blasters on the hands there. and different colours on the one in the centre. But she's got an upper torso swivel there. Really can't move forward too much, but plenty of movement side to side. No other waist articulation. You do get, you can see the pins up there that allow that articulation on the thighs. So there's pretty good movement on them, as well as swivel thighs up at the tops. So again, quite a good range of movement on this figure. Double joints at the knees and articulated ankles as well. A little bit limited by the suit and the way that it kind of works, but if you twist it around, you can actually, there you go, you can get a good stance there. And of course, peg holes for those stands which Hasbro never make, or don't make anymore. But she's a really good one. I like this figure. I'm very impressed with this figure overall. It's another great, unique and different Iron Man suit. Let's hope this gets to come out in the line at some point, even a paint variation or something different, but I really like it. Very cool indeed. Love to know your thoughts. What do you think of the Marvel Unlimited subscription? There are some limitations to the app. It's available both on Android and on iOS. You get plenty of platforms there catered for, at least to get all these comics on your tablet or phone or whatever you want to read them on. Phone would be kind of hard, but tablet is pretty good. But my Android tablet really, and it's the same on iOS, will only allow, the Marvel subscription will only allow you to download something like 12 comics, I think, at a go. So you've got to download 12, read them, and then upload them. So it's a weird kind of limit that they have there, which kind of sucks. And a lot of the fresher comics, brand new comics, don't make it to the app for quite some time. So it's a little bit like Netflix. Some shows don't appear very early, but there are some exclusives. So it's a kind of, I don't know, it's a weird kind of way they do it. Now, you can subscribe to the club and pay a monthly fee, but you don't get this figure and some of the other goodies as well, so you only get access to the digital comics. So I think it's certainly worthwhile doing this if you're a Legends fan or an Iron Man fan, but that's just me. I'm a crazy collector. Let me know what you think of the figure and or this pack. I'd love to know your thoughts on this. Do you subscribe? What about the DC equivalent? Do you subscribe to that? Love to hear your thoughts and comments. Please let us know. The comments are below. Again, there'll be a link to the Marvel Unlimited Club directly underneath the video too. If you're brand new to the channel, click subscribe and we'll send you lots of cool reviews straight into your inbox. Lots of interviews and other goodies. That's it. We'll see you for another review coming up.